Good evening and welcome to my How Healthy Are You weekly educational podcast. My name is Dr. Thomas Brewer. I'm a PhD chemist and nutritional blood microscopist. We had three questions for this week's podcast. The first one, quite simple. The question was, how good is nutritional yeast? It's really good. Nutritional yeast is something that you can buy even in the grocery store, but definitely in most vitamin stores. And what's so good about it is a complete protein. So it has all 18 essential fatty acids. It has a mild flavor. It's good for seasoning all sorts of different foods. And it's definitely something to keep in your pantry. So nutritional yeast is a good protein source and essential fatty acid source. So the next question is about the plant enzymes. And these are the plant enzymes that I provide. Now, the question was, why do I need to take various brands of plant enzymes when someone's already taking a plant enzyme? And it's a really good question because there's so many different plant enzymes out there. And I've always said there is no such thing as a bad plant enzyme or a bad enzyme blend or a bad digestive enzyme. It's just how much are you going to get ripped off buying the product. So in order to determine the activity of a particular enzyme blend, one of the best ways that separates the good ones from the bad ones is to look at the amount of protease enzyme in there. That's the enzyme that digests proteins. And the unit for protease digestive capability is HUT. Now, that stands for how much enzyme it takes to hydrolyze casein, a type of protein that's in a lot of protein powders, the amount of enzyme to hydrolyze casein to give a certain amount of tyrosine, and that's where the T comes from. So it's a hydrolysis reaction, and that's where the H comes from. The U is for units. So hydrolysis units of tyrosine. Well, we really don't care about that. We just need to know, well, what kind of a number would be good? And most plant enzymes and digestive enzymes on the market per capsule are somewhere between 5,000 HUTs per capsule, and I've seen them as high as 30 and 35,000. The enzymes I provide are 130,000. They're many times, often 10 times more active than other enzymes. Then the next question comes, and it's always about price. So the manufacturer of the enzymes I provide has a challenge, and he's had this challenge ever since I've knew him, which was 15 years ago. And that challenge is, if you can find a similar enzyme for less money, he'll provide you $1,000. Well, he's never paid. He's never had to pay that $1,000. And numerous people think they can pick up a quick thousand. All they have to do is go to Amazon and find an enzyme that costs less. Well, that becomes even a challenge because the enzymes you're going to buy on Amazon are typically 90 count. And the ones I provide are 270 count. So right there, the product better be more than a third less money, let alone the activity units being one-tenth or worse. Typically, most of the products that I've found are about 30 times more expensive, so the value is just, there really isn't a comparison. Now, one way a person can check the enzyme versus any other enzyme, so the enzymes I provide versus any other enzyme, is do what's called the oatmeal test. And in that test, you prepare a packet of instant oatmeal in a glass. typically an 8-ounce glass or something like that. And you take it out of the microwave, you let it cool a little bit, but still warm, plenty warm, and you open up one of my enzymes in there. Within 10 seconds, that firm oatmeal will be completely liquefied, and you can stir it with a spoon. It will have the consistency of water, not of thick oatmeal. So I challenge you to find another enzyme that does that with one capsule. So I have done this with many other brands of enzymes, and I've had to use 30 capsules, and it would take 10 to 15 minutes with 30 capsules. So just no comparison. And that is not a protein test. That is more of a fiber and carbohydrate test. So good enzyme blends will digest proteins, carbohydrates. The amylase is what digests carbohydrates. Lipase is what digests fats. Cellulase is a fiber digestion. Sucrase, enzyme to digest sugars. Maltase, also for sugars. Lactase for sugars. Galactosidase is in very good enzyme blends, and that's to reduce gas. Bromelains also to eliminate a lot of inflammation. Well, then the question is, well, what makes these enzymes 30 times more active than many on the market and easily 2 to 5 times more active than the more expensive enzymes? And it's because of the mineral blend. Enzymes can't function without a coenzyme, and coenzymes are vitamins and minerals. So they work hand in hand. That is why when people start taking enzymes, they notice their vitamins work better, or the nutrition in their diet starts feeding them more efficiently. Well, that's because enzymes and vitamins and minerals work together. This is a very unique mineral blend in the enzymes I provide. No one else has this mineral blend, and that's why the enzymes are so active. And based on activity, they're the best value. But please, let me know if you find an enzyme that costs less than what I'm charging for 270 count and has 130,000 units of HUT, and that's just a protein digestion number. That's not comparing the carbohydrate and fat digestion numbers. So that's what I wanted to say about the enzymes. Like I say, there's plenty out there, but I'm always looking for better value to provide my clients, and I haven't found it in 15 years. Now, the final question I had for this podcast is about the Sterilmax, again, another Enriching Gifts product. And often when people read the nutritional label of the Sterilmax, they say, oh, I can't have this, it has soy. I can't have this, this has wheat. And I say, well, what does it say? Does it say soy or does it say soy sprout? And they say, well, it says soy sprout. And how about wheat? Yeah, wheat sprout. Well, it turns out that the chemistry of a sprout is completely different than the chemistry of the plant. And the difference between a sprout and a plant as an agricultural difference is a sprout does not have a leaf. So the ingredients that's in the Sterilmax, these sprouts are true sprouts. There's no leaf. They're not like the sprouts in the store with leaves on them. What happens is when a sprout starts to form a leaf, it's technically called a plant, but chemically, the glycosides, it's a chemical that feeds your white blood cells. The content of these glycosides drops around 90-95%. So I tell people, if you need glycosides to feed your white blood cells, take the Sterilmax. And people say, well, I'll just grow sprouts. Okay, so you can grow soy, fenugreek, barley, and wheat sprouts, and that's the combination that works best. But you have to harvest them before a leaf forms. And if you can do that, absolutely put those in a blender have them as a part of your smoothie, and you will increase your white blood cell activity. For most people, it's very difficult to do that and a lot easier to buy Sterilmax. Now, these glycosides are in the optimum ratio to feed the white blood cells. And there is no other product on the market that has these glycosides, which are from what's called sterolins. So you have sterolins and glycosides. And I know this gets confusing because there's glucose, glycogen, glucagon, and glycosides. So it gets confusing with all these chemical terms that start with GLYC. But as a chemist, these glycosides that are from the sterolin, so the sterolin content and the ratio of glycosides to sterolins cannot be beat. It's the next best product is about 1% as active as the Sterilmax. And that's an even worse difference than the other enzymes out there when comparing the plant enzymes. So I believe I have found an absolutely great product line for my clients, and I've been using it for 15 years. And I still look to see if somebody has a better sterolin to glycoside ratio, and I have not found it. So this Sterilmax is the absolute best way to keep your white blood cells large, which means strong, and moving, which means active. And if you have a strong and active immune system, well, the evidence is in the white blood cells. So the white blood cells are synonymous with your immune system. And so are the probiotic bacteria in your gut. They are also a big part of the system in our body called the immune system. But white cells are where it's at. And when I look at someone's blood and I notice they have active white blood cells, I tell them, you have great white blood cells, and they say, thank you. And what typically happens is their whole family has good white cells. It's a genetic trait. At least it seems to be when I look at a family's blood, I can see which parent gave the children the active white blood cells. And those with active white cells typically have a lot of longevity. And that's really the end game when I teach people about health and nutrition and diet and exercise. It's all about quality of life and longevity. That's the end goal, high quality of life and longevity. So having active white cells is the way to get there. At least it's a main part of it. Now, that's all I have for this podcast. I wanted to remind everyone that I've been uploading a number of videos to YouTube under my channel, Dr. Thomas Brewer, and these are short. These are 3 to 5 minute videos, so no excuse not to watch them. And of course, if you like something, please click the like button and subscribe so you'll get notified as I upload more. I've been uploading about one a day, and I'll be doing that probably till the end of the month or about then. So let me know what you think of these videos. If you could leave a comment, I read all the comments, and I'd like to know other topics to talk about and what people think. But one thing I wanted to do with these is to keep them short. Okay, so I'll be doing another podcast next Monday, assuming we get past the next 2 days and the world survives. So until then, don't keep me a secret. Thanks for listening.